Good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for inviting me. It's an honour to be stood here taking part in such a historic tradition. Now, I cannot condemn hookup culture, and it's not that I don't think hookup culture doesn't have its drawbacks. Sadly, the benefits of friends with benefits does not involve reducing your tax bill. But no, seriously, there are very valid arguments for not participating in hookup culture. And if you agree with those reasons, I would implore you to not participate. I've got plenty of friends that do committed relationships or nothing at all. The wonderful thing about the rise of hookup culture is that it's not just about casual sex. It's also about the freedom to choose. And is that not a huge part of what the feminist movement has been fighting for? The freedom for women to choose what they do with their bodies and their lives. This debate is calling into question women's own agency over what they choose to do regarding their bodies and sexuality. If anything, it infantilizes women to say that hookup culture is detrimental to feminism. It suggests that women do not know what's best for them. Is this conversation not just another attempt to seize back control over women's bodies under the guise of protection? Protection from what? What are we being liberated from when we say that women do not deserve the choice to participate in hookup culture? And who is it that's really doing the protecting? Is it the carceral feminists, or as I like to call them, pick-me's, who would like to control other women through masculine and fundamentally patriarchal means? Is it men? Is it the men who love to consume pornography but cannot stand the thought that their next girlfriend might have a body count higher than one? And look, I don't know, maybe sleeping with Jack that you met at Prism could be the final nail in the coffin for feminism and not the trans-exclusionary radicals or our reproductive rights being whipped out from underneath us as we speak. Now, I would like to tackle the subject of unsatisfactory hookups for women. Are all hookups about men using women as a means to satisfy themselves? I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to be brave, and I'm going to say no. Some of my female friends have had some of their most enjoyable sexual experiences to date due to a random hookup or a friends with benefits relationship. Now, of course, not every hookup is going to be satisfying, particularly when you're taking a chance on someone that you may have only just met. But if that's so, there is no obligation for you to go back and do it again. Now, I do want to take this moment to make sure that we're all very clear that if it's a hookup, then it's consensual, and if it's not consensual, it's not a hookup, it's assault, and that is a topic that I will come back to later. But as I was saying, if the hookup was unsatisfactory, you do not have to go back and do it again. But if you are in a friends with benefits scenario or a situationship, then you can communicate or learn to communicate. Yes, my dear friends of the house, we might actually learn something out of hookup culture. Having sexual experiences with various people may broaden your horizons, as well as help you understand what you like and dislike, both in sex, but also in a potential partner, should you want one of those. I also don't think that unsatisfactory sexual experiences for women are even a symptom of hookup culture. I think they're a symptom of something else. I'm sure there are plenty of women who are in marriages or established relationships that have also never had a satisfactory sexual experience either. I think, you know, unsatisfactory sex in marriage is issue enough that they even made an entire film about it starring Emma Thompson just earlier this year. I think these mediocre or unsatisfactory sexual experiences are really just an argument for us to take a more comprehensive and pleasure-based approach to sex education for both young people and adults. And I honestly believe not only might we end up decreasing the number of unsatisfactory sexual experiences, but we also could aid in helping people realise when they have been sexually assaulted. You might have fewer people leaving a situation and writing off as, I guess that's just what sex is like. But on the topic of sexual violence and hookup culture, I don't think hookup culture can be blamed. Sexual violence can be enacted by family members, friends, colleagues, anybody. I'm not sure that hookup culture can be posited as the villain or even a proponent of sexual violence being allowed to occur. I fear that when we condemn hookup culture and seek to bring it down, we are ignoring all of the wonderful benefits that it has for people. Sex is natural and instinctual for most of the population. It's part of how humans communicate and express feelings. For some people, hookup culture allows them to express themselves in ways that they can't in other aspects of their life. Those who are questioning their sexuality may partake in hookup culture to better understand who they are. Those who are not ready to, safe to, or perhaps simply do not want to openly express their sexuality are also able to use hookup culture to have the experiences that they desire but may not otherwise be able to have. Hookups are something that we get to pick and choose if and when we participate in them. People go through all of these various different phases of their life, and sometimes a committed relationship simply isn't right for that time. Committing to a relationship is a lot of work. Putting your heart and soul into somebody can be absolutely wonderful, but it is time and energy consuming. I've seen far too many of my peers being held back by the relationships that they are in. Hannah Rosen wrote in The Atlantic, "With the rise of hookup culture, women have the opportunity and freedom to delay marriage and have temporary relationships that don't derail their education or career." Rejected. And perhaps that's the real liberation. Perhaps that's the real liberation, women being able to focus on themselves. I think when we all look back on The Devil Wears Prada, we realise that Miranda Priestly wasn't the villain. It was Anne Hathaway's character's boyfriend for trying to hold her back. But look, what I'm getting at here is that hookup culture is not a thing that most people choose to participate in for the rest of their lives. It's something that people are able to pick and choose if and when they participate in it and when it suits them best. Some women feel liberated when they participate in hookup culture and others don't. The same goes for men and non-binary people. Whether casual sex, committed relationship sex, or no sex at all makes you feel liberated, that is your choice. What you decide to do with your body and your time is your choice. Women's liberation will not begin with the abolition of choice. Thank you.